Hi viewers, welcome to our electrical engineering lecture channel for most interactive sessions of different subjects of electronic and electrical engineering. For the latest updates and videos, don't forget to subscribe and click the like button.
Assalamu alaikum everyone. In today's lecture of digital signal processing, we will be discussing the reconstruction of band limited signals in context of the sampling process. So just to have a quick review of the basic rules of sampling. So in time domain, the conversion of continuous time into discrete time signal is governed by this particular expression, t is equal to nt, or you can also say small n is equal to t over capital T. And in frequency domain, the same mapping can also be written as small omega is equal to capital omega into t, where omega s is equal to 2 pi over capital T, where T is the sampling period. Now to start with the concept of reconstruction, and let us consider an arbitrary Fourier transform of a continuous time signal, denoted by this particular thing. This particular transform xc of j omega on the capital omega axis, which is radians per second, and assuming that the maximum frequency content is from minus omega n to capital omega n. Now when we perform sampling, the basic concept is that this spectrum xc of j omega will be shifted at the integral multiples of omega s. So let's see how this shifting happens. This is omega n, this is minus omega n, and if we assume that omega s is somewhere over here, then this then the next copy will be around omega s, so that this point becomes omega s plus omega n, and this point is omega s minus omega n on the omega axis, and same happening at minus omega s, so that this point is minus omega s plus omega n, and this point is minus omega s minus omega n. So this is xs of j omega. When we multiply the continuous time signal with an impulse train, this is what happens in frequency domain. And when we convert this CTFT into DTFT by using this mapping, that is, we multiply the x-axis with the sampling period capital T, then the shape will remain the same, but it will be converted into DTFT so that this point becomes small omega n, this is 0, and this point is 2 pi. So instead of the copies at the integral multiples of omega s, now the copies appear at integral multiples of 2 pi, and here it is minus 2 pi. And the axis is small omega is equal to capital omega into T. Now if we perform if we want to perform reconstruction, then we need a low pass filter having bandwidth of omega s by 2, like this. We pass this x of e raised to power j omega through a filter having omega s by 2 in continuous domain, and discrete domain it is having frequencies of pi. The cutoff frequency is pi, this is also pi. If we pass this signal through this low pass filter, then the output becomes the original spectrum from minus omega n to omega n, and this is omega is equal to capital omega into T. So this is reconstructed signal in discrete time. But if the process of reconstruction, we need to multiply this omega, we need to divide this omega by capital T to convert the axis into capital omega. So after this process, we will be having the original signal from minus omega n to omega n. So this is basically your reconstructed signal on the axis of capital omega. So this filter, which is the low pass filter, is called the ideal reconstruction filter. Ideal is because it is completely a rectangular filter. So ideal reconstruction filter. Ideal reconstruction filter. So this is what is happening in the frequency domain. Now, categorically, if we see what is the process of reconstruction, we have the sample signal x of n. First of all, we will convert this signal into xs of t, and that will be through multiplication with an impulse train, like we done in the sampling process. Same impulse train s of t, and then this signal will be passed through an ideal reconstruction filter, which is hr of t, to result in the recovered signal or reconstructed signal x or xr of t. Now, this is our let's say this is our sample signal x of n. Just be represented by a dotted line to give it an envelope. If these are the samples, let's say at minus 1, 0, 1, 2, and so on with the axis of n, we multiply it with an impulse train s of t, and that impulse train is given by this time domain plot. Which is located at minus t, 0, t, 2t, and so on the time axis. When we multiply them together, we will result in the same kind of signal which we encountered in the sampling process, xs of t, that will be having shape like this. Again, it is a weighted impulse train from minus t, 0, t, 2t, and so on the time axis, right? So basically we are going to multiply the discrete time signal x of n with the impulse train s of t. So this xs of t will be the product of x of n multiplied by s of t. So I can also write it as x of n multiplied by summation delta n minus, sorry, delta t minus nt, t minus n capital T. I can also write it as, if I take x of n inside the summation, so it will become x of n delta t minus n capital T. So this is your xs of t. Now this xs of t here will be passed through this reconstruction filter. So if reconstruction filter has the impulse response hr of t and it is an LTI system, so the output xr of t, the reconstructed signal, that will be equal to xs of t convolved with hr of t, right? So now we substitute the value from equation 1. So from 1, xr of t will become summation n x of n delta of t minus nt. This is basically xs of t and convolved with hr of t. Now when these two signals are convolved with each other, again the properties, shifting property of impulse will be invoked. So by using the shifting property of impulse, what will happen? The end result will be like this: summation x of n and hr of t minus nt. So this is the recovered signal. Right, now we'll see what does it mean. What does this particular equation mean? To understand this particular equation, let's see what is basically a reconstruction filter in frequency domain and in time domain. First of all, let's see in frequency domain. As we already seen that in frequency domain, reconstruction filter is simply like this. On the axis of omega, it is truly an ideal filter in the rectangular shape and having the cutoff frequency of omega s by 2, which is actually equal to pi by capital T, and minus omega s by 2 equal to minus pi over capital T, and the value of capital T, or the gain can also be changed, but in general the gain of this reconstruction filter is said to be capital T. Now if this is a rect function, From the Fourier transform pair, you should know that the inverse Fourier transform of this rect function will be a sinc function, and that will be given as hr of t in the form of a sinc as sine of pi t over capital T divided by pi t over capital T. So this is a sinc function. Now, to find out the zero crossings of the sinc function, you always put this argument equal to plus minus n pi. So that becomes pi t over capital T equals plus minus n pi. This pi will be cancelled out and T will be equal to plus minus n capital T. It means this sinc will have zero crossings at the integral multiples of the sampling period. So if I draw this sinc over here, hr of t, it will be like this. This is 0, this is capital T, this is 2t, and so on. Here it is minus t, is minus 2t, and so on, with the amplitude of 1. So this is the basically impulse response of this particular reconstruction filter. But now if you see this equation, let's call it equation number 2. From this equation number 2, if you see, in order to reconstruct the signal or in order to synthesize xr of t, this equation utilizes the delayed impulse response of this reconstruction filter, this one, because it is using hr of t minus nt. So we have to delay. So first, what we are going to do, for each value of n, we will multiply x of n with a correspondingly delayed impulse response of the reconstruction filter. So to further understand this, let us write over here that for n is equal to 0, we will have xr of t equals x of 0 multiplied by h of t. For n is equal to 1, let's say xr of t will be equal to x of 1 multiplied by h of t minus capital T, and so on. And then add all together, add all of them together. So you can say that these impulse responses, each impulse response will be weighted by the corresponding values of x of n, and then all the resultants will be added up to result in the final reconstructed signal. So let's say this one is the hr of t. Now if I draw h of t minus capital T, it will be centered around capital T because it is delayed by capital T. So that will become like this. And similarly, again, for h of t minus 2t, let us label it as h of t minus capital T, hr. And for the next one, it will be centered around 2t, and that will be equal to like this. So this is hr of t minus 2 capital T. So all these delayed impulse responses will be weighted by the corresponding values of x of n, and all those resultants will be added up. And in that fashion, if you perform all these computations and add them together, what will happen in time domain? Let me show you over here from this particular, yes, this one. So you see, this is the continuous time signal. This is xs of t. And this is how you reconstruct hr of t. You see, there are many, many, many impulse responses in the form of sinc functions, and they are weighted differently. You see, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, each having different amplitudes, because the amplitudes are coming from the weighting, and that weighting is coming from the values of x of n. So there are if I speak theoretically, there are infinite sinc functions, and each of these sinc functions is weighted by the value of x of n, and then all are added up point by point. If you see, if I add them, all the dotted sinc functions, then I can have this kind of signal. If I add them point by point, then I will get this red line, and this red line is completely in accordance with the actual continuous time signal. So in this way, by using infinite sinc functions theoretically and weighting them with the value of x of n and adding them together point by point, will result in the reconstructed signal. So these are two different aspects. In frequency domain, I have shown you that just by passing through a filter, you can always extract the original spectrum. And in time domain, this is happening, that by the use of infinite sinc functions, we can always reconstruct the signal. If I just write one more equation to further tell you what is happening. xr of t will be equal to summation n minus infinity to infinity x of n. In place of the impulse response, we will have sync functions. So it will be sync of pi t minus n capital T over capital T divided by pi t minus n capital T over capital T. So this is basically the governing equation in time domain for the reconstruction of signals. So that is all for the reconstruction in the sampling process. Thank you for listening.